goes,
and machismo are in the air tonight. The competition for the prison's weightlifting championship is about to begin.
It's real, baby. It's real.
Yeah.
You want me?
Yes, you can, baby.
What's
right on?
What's on?
Yes, sir.
Guys, all ready? The big boys is in the house. Nothing but champions. State champions, baby.
Time to ride.
Evil in the house.
Everybody's got to go down this end. They want to get a group picture of all you guys.
Representing for the handicap, strike. Representing for the handicap.
We're going to start with the 123, 148, 165, and 181 class. The bigger fellas are going last, just like we always do it. We're going to do all the squatting tonight. We're going to do all the benching tomorrow night. We're going to do all the deadlifts on Monday night. Start warming up, first three classes. We're going to start in 10 minutes.
Lifting weights on the street is a little different because you got everything out there to be happy about. But being in prison here is in a very oppressive place, so you got to find ways to basically uplift your spirits and not sulk. So this is our hideaway here in the gym.
You know, when we have our bad days, you know, we'll just come in here and we'll release that pain because we don't want to release it on no inmates, you know what I'm saying?
What these weights does, they alleviate a lot of aggression that one could definitely turn outward toward another human being. It channels all of that negativity and all of that energy build up during the day of not doing anything. This is the glue that keeps us together. But
whenever I give you the okay to squat, my arm go down, I'm going to say squat too. Go down and come right back up. Don't wait on me. All that I'm going to do after that, I'm going to tell you to rack it.
Now don't wait at the bottom.
Come on,
okay,
man.
Bar's loaded.
Here we go.
Come on. Set it off, LL. Talk to it. Talk to it.
Getting caught. Good eye. Here we go.
I won the state champ this year in the 220 weight class, but it makes me feel good to be a, you know, to be a champ.
State champ? I ain't the champ for nothing.
You got some of the hardcore dudes in prison, you know, and everybody want to be the man in prison, really, you know what I'm saying? They want to shine and want the big name, you know, but sports is what make you shine in here, you know, not what you had on the street. People don't care about that. They don't, you know, that's the same penitentiary stories that you hear every day.
Here we go.
Linebacker status.
Guys, here we go.
Good
luck out. Good lockout.
I got money.
Down we go. Good dip. Bring it up. Go to racket.
Stay chill.
Good job.
I refuse to lose.
Good job.
Good job.
All natural, baby.
Good job.
I like when I have to fight something. You know what I'm saying? It take a lot of pain away that I go through. A lot of stress, you know what I mean? That's what we do it for the love of it. For the love of it, yeah.
Bell, you next.
Where your mind at? Yeah, where your mind at?
He does a good job getting himself.
I have six other brothers, and a lot of them off into bodybuilding or powerlifting. I got a couple of brothers who are professional powerlifters, but I've been involved in weights itself since I was 11 and 12 years old. Everybody's competitive in the family. That's a family tradition, you know, always pushing the envelope.
There he goes. Good concentration.
Yes, sir.
There we go.
Lightweight.
Squat. Down we go. Good down.
Right now, I feel powerful. I feel positive. And I don't feel that there's anybody in this prison in my weight class that could outlift me in any other, in any given day.
For a long time. The first one is the best one. I just needed to get this on the board.
Squat. Good job.
About a year and a half ago, the rivalry between the white and blacks was pretty bad. And this time, they're rooting for each other. They want everybody to succeed. And I noticed that myself. I like that part of it. Because in here it's just, it's not white and black. It's, we're all together.
That's the Holy Spirit inside me, man. You know what I'm talking about? Don't look at Hank. Look at what God can do in any man's life.
He always gets fired up. He gets all the rest of them fired up, too, when he does that. You know, he ain't paying attention to everybody else. He's in his own.
It's a technique sport. You know, if you don't have the mechanics and your technique right, you could really be hurt. I've seen some guys break their backs on the street and in prison doing squats.
Squat!
Hit it!
Squat.
Squat.
There we go.
Come on!
Off the dance. Get it. Get
it. Get
it. Get it. Walk it out.
Hey, don't worry about it, man.
Don't
worry about it,
Ain't my day.
That's all you got yours, baby.
This is step one. We got step two and step three to go.
We're gonna have one more lift after this. As soon as it's over, I gotta get you back to the house.
We talking about the Lord. We talking about the Lord. We talking about we gonna do it. He had a light here. He come to save the world. The sins of the world. He come to do it.
Good lift.
It's gonna be better.
Yeah, we win in our weight class. That's the main thing, you know. Yeah, we just going for all time personal.
Monday,
you know what I'm saying? Our
Monday's
best.
Gonna be the best.
Yeah.
I just couldn't execute those last two lifts, man. Mm-hmm. I had it, but it just rolled on my neck. I couldn't recover.
Yeah.
You know, because I felt myself here.
Yeah.
Coming up. But yeah. I just could have had to dunk.
But you was up higher than that. You was that far from locking out. Yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
We still got two events. We got the bench tomorrow.
Yeah, we winning on
weight. And the deadlift is going to be the best lift.
Day two of the prison's annual weightlifting championship is underway. Robel Givens holds the state prison's record for the bench press in the 220-pound division. Tonight, he's going for 420 pounds, 5 pounds above his state record.
Good press.
Oh, you got it. Easy,
man.
Come on.
Yes!
Go!
Give me my rep.
Good job. Yeah, feels good.
He didn't wait for a rec signal. So that 420 pounds was no good. He'll have to lift on his neck, make his third attempt for the record.
I got it, but I racked it too quick. I gotta wait for the judges to say rack. All the yelling going around, I couldn't really hear him say it.
This may be a sporting event, but the participants are far from ordinary. In this weight room, there are murderers, armed robbers, rapists, and standover thugs. The one thing that unites them is their criminality.
This is a dangerous room, because if somebody gets out of line and don't care, take a 5-pound plate and knock you out, you know, you're done. And It's never happened yet. Nobody's used one. We had a guy come out of the basketball court one time, took a plate and was heading out the door with it. We stopped him. He was going to go out there and use it as a weapon. Fender Bell got into it with a fellow over there, and I went and got right in between them, and I probably shouldn't have. They were like face off to each other and doing this thing, you know, and I stopped that because they were both big guys.
One, two, three.
That day he was mad. I knew if I didn't go over and get between them two guys and they got hooked up, I was going to have to call in troops because I would have been able to handle it. But he backed off. But, you know, once they got started, you couldn't stop them. Not by yourself. But they have enough sense, too, to know that if they ever do anything in here, it's going to go down the tubes. So they protect that a lot.
Bill's getting his bar ready for him. Gibbons is now sitting on the bench. Getting Harry Lane's back, getting a hold of the bar. Waiting for the signal. Here we go. Full lock down, pause. We've got the press signal.
Weightlifting, a lot of officers would like to take it out because they think that they get big. But a big old tired weightlifter is a lot less of a threat than a little skinny guy who's out there doing nothing, walking around. Bell and Gibbons come in here and for an hour and a half just give it all they got. They don't have enough energy to get into any trouble when they leave here.
Yeah.
You know, the more I can get them to do, keep their mind off of other stuff, you know, this is a bad place. You know, it's a real bad place. I wouldn't want to live here.